For the old days, to make a web server, for example, is available to access via the internet, you have to deploy DDNS through supported ISP router. Normally, if you want to visit your home web server from outside, you need to set up dynamic DNS because your ISP doesn't give you a static public IP address. But some ISPs in the world don't even assign a dynamic public IP address to each subscriber. Many subscribers share a single public IP address. In this scenario, dynamic DNS won't work, and that's where PageKite comes in, linuxbabe.com. With PageKite, you have your own dedicated IP address that can be claimed at the time you run the back end Python script. With tunneled reverse proxy that can bypass NATs, firewalls, so your local web servers, SSH servers, or even IP cameras can be accessed publicly through the internet. This is impossible if you are using a shared Wi-Fi network or a LTE dongle, so this is the key difference versus no IP. With proper router configuration in conjunction with no IP, you can remote access your router, IP, cameras, smart home IoT devices on the fly. Both PageKite and no IP provide free subdomain names with the capacity of name to custom domains, so you can enjoy the free plan without paying a penny. To integrating with your own top level domain name, upgrade to their premium plan with an affordable domain at profit server. Fast, reliable, secure, make your local host part of the web. PageKite has led the way in making local servers public. With relays on 4 continents, it works with any computer, any web server, and any internet connection. PageKite makes essential services are available by default: HTTP, HTTPS, SSH, TCP, base ports, firewalls that you have to do by yourself with no IP, port forwarding, firewall opening, etc. Furthermore, PageKite secures communications with wildcard relay certs or end-to-end TLS that push privacy and security of your servers into a new level. For free users, you get 3 subdomains on a limited selection of domain name options, but these subdomains will never expire as long as you confirm activity every 30 days. You also get port forwarding and URL forwarding, which can be useful depending on your use case. It's a pretty basic but robust package. Make use of .com. For basic services like remote router accessing, camera IP viewing, etc., you should go with dynamic DNS like NoIP to get the best performance. You can leverage port forward of the router to administrating multiple devices. PageKite is for who need the dedicated IP address, routers, independent, DDNS, unsupported equipment. Check out high-performance routers here. It should be noted that with the free DDNS providers, there will be a few limitations. You will not be allowed to choose just any URL and expect that it will be forwarded to your server. After you have chosen a host name, you will have a limited selection of domains you will be allowed to choose from. Make a teachier.com. There is one mandatory precondition for DDNS to work. You must have a static or dynamic public IP address. Dynamic DNS will not work with a shared public IP. You can read up more on this in our article on private and public IP addresses. The easiest way to find out this information is to log into the router's web UI and check the WAN widget in the overview page. You will be automatically redirected to the overview page after you log in, and the WAN widget will be on the right side of the page. Second widget from the top, Teltonika LTE. Each router modem vendors have their own implementations about DDNS. Make sure the wiki manual page for vendor specific tutorials are there. Take care on security tightly though. Exposing devices services on the internet opens certain risks about DDoS attack, botnet involving, malware, etc. Follow my channel for the latest news about security folklore.